Hi, this is Heather with KeepItSimpleSocialMedia.com. And today we're going to answer Melvin Lemerick's question. And Melvin sells real estate in beautiful Vancouver, British Columbia. And what Melvin is asking is, if she's on her personal profile on Facebook, on her newsfeed, where all her friends and other pages that she's liked, all their information is fed into, and she sees an article that she really likes and would like to put it on her business page, she wants to know how she can do that. And it's really easy to share information on social sites. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to do that. And then, Melvin, I will answer your question about coming back to Vancouver to do a refresher course and learn a little bit more about how to utilize Facebook for business, because it's a lot to learn in 3.5 hours to build a page and learn how to run it. We forget a lot of things, and there are some very powerful tools on Facebook that as a real estate agent you can be using to help market your business. But first, let's head over to my personal profile on Facebook. Now, when I go onto Facebook for the very first time, I actually don't land on my wall. I land on my home tab. So I'm going to take us to the home tab. And here is where everyone lands when you log on to Facebook for the first time. And let's just pretend we're going through our news feed and we find a story that we want to share. So let's say Marge's story here. This is a great one, and especially for real estate agents. Thank you, Marge. What we have is a very good article to read about converting more deals. Enough about branding. Let's make some deals. So what I say to myself is, this is a great article to share on my business page with my fellow colleagues, perhaps. So what I want to do is go ahead and click this share button right here. I might want to like it, first of all, to let Marge know that, thank you, I enjoyed this article. Then I want to click the share button. From here, I don't want to put it on my personal profile timeline, so I need to click this little arrow. And then it gives me choices of what I'd like to do with it. And let's just go right down to where it says on your page. Now, if you're like me, I have several Facebook business pages created as examples for when I'm teaching and training. So I actually have to click on the one that I don't want in order to see the other pages that I have to choose the page that I do want. And then I go ahead and click on it. And it will go ahead and it will put it over to my business page. As you can see here, it says it's on your business page now, Heather. But before I click the share link, I want to write something. And Facebook even gives you a prompt right here. It says write something. So if I click in the box, I want to write something that would make people want to talk back to me, want to answer my question. So I might say, I don't know about you, but I sure could use some business off of Facebook, or how is your business on Facebook? So it all depends what you want to write, but you want to engage with the people that are going to receive this message, so they either are going to click your like button or give you a comment or share the article. And you could even say, please go ahead and share this article on your page. I found it extremely valuable. And then people will probably share it. And that creates more talking about on your business page, which is the overall goal on your page. So let's go ahead and I'm going to cancel this because I'm not going to share it on my business page. But I wanted to show you one other thing, especially for real estate agents. So what I did when I got Melvin's message was I wanted to try to find her business page to have a look at it. So because I know Melvin took my class, I know that she would have linked her business page onto her personal profile. But something else is more important. As a real estate agent, there are rules and regulations with the real estate council that we need to tell the public what real estate company that we work for. So when I went into your about section, Melvin, I think it would be very beneficial if, work in education, realtor at Sutton West Coast Realty, that's perfect. But over on your business page, so I'm now over on your business page, and I click on your About section, I think it would be very beneficial if you went ahead and put your contact information for the real estate company that you're licensed at right in the very beginning of your information. And I recommend that for all real estate agents. Once again, Malveen, thank you so much for your questions. And yes, if you put a group of 5 to 10 people together, because I keep my classes relatively small, I will come over to Vancouver and I will sit with you for 2.5 hours or 2 hours, and I will give you some hands-on computer training with your laptop on how to utilize Facebook to be successful at marketing. I'll talk to you a little bit about promoted posts, about ads, and about sponsored ads on how you can work with your sellers on that, and how you can work with other people within your real estate community, so other like-minded businesses, perhaps mortgage brokers, home inspectors, home stagers, lawyers, that type of idea, and how you can all work together to build your business and market on Facebook. And there's a nominal fee for each person, but we can discuss that between you and I if you send me a private message here on Facebook. Thank you very much for your questions. Remember, when you have a question to do with social media, please write it directly on my Facebook wall, not in a private message, but directly on my wall. Thank you very much, Malveen, for the question, and good luck with your Facebook business page. I'm happy to hear that you're going to get working on it. Let's keep it simple.